From Hopkins High School, ParkTV Sports presents the 2016 Section 6AA Girls Soccer Tournament featuring the St. Louis Park Orioles and the Hopkins Royals. Hi, everybody. I'm Howard Luloff welcoming you back to Hopkins High School, where the St. Louis Park boys got eliminated by the Hopkins Royals 2-0 in the Section 6AA boys quarterfinal. Hopkins advancing to the semifinal Saturday afternoon against the Minneapolis Washburn Cooper winner. Now it's the girls' turn to take the spotlight here at Hopkins High School as the St. Louis Park Orioles, out of the Metro West Conference with a record of 9 wins, 4 losses, and 1 tie, take on the Hopkins Royals from the Lake Conference, a record of 10 wins, 5 losses, and 1 tie. Andy Ewald, the activities director of St. Louis Park, has just entered the press box, but he'll not be connected to a headset, so it'll be just yours truly. The Orioles got off to a slow start this season, losing 3 of their first games, going 0-3, losing 3 straight by identical 1-0 scores, and you were not watching a rerun. Those were the same scores for the first 3 games. After an 0-3 start, the Orioles have gone 9 wins, 1 loss, and 1 tie. As the starting lineups have been introduced, Anna Roethler will be in the net for the Orioles. Jordan Petty will mind the net for the Hopkins Royals. The officials for the boys for the girls game, which is now underway, Jack Chen, Matt Tiano, and Bryce Brocken. It'll be a throw-in for the Royals. 15 seconds into the game. We're glad you can join us from Hopkins High School. Second game of a Section 6AA doubleheader. The Hopkins boys advanced with a 2-0 win over the Orioles, and that's Ellie Kent for the Orioles, daughter of longtime St. Louis Park head coach Benji Kent. As there's a race for the ball in the Oriole territory, that's Lavin Douglas for Hopkins. Now it's Abby Mandler for the Royals, and there is a foul on the play. It will be a free kick for the Royals that'll be taken by Chance Douglas. Chance, the sister of Lavin Douglas. As Chance takes the shot, and Roethler with the save. Roethler getting the start in almost every game this season for the Orioles. Anya Lindell Peterson did get some playing time on senior night against the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights, which we'll get to in a moment. That's Ashley Aiken for Hopkins. And it's Alex Balfour for St. Louis Park. It'll be a throw-in for Hopkins, 37:58 to go in the opening half. The two teams met on October 1st, and they play to a 0-0 tie. No goals were scored. That's Rafferty Kugler for the Orioles. There's a centering pass. Intercepted by Allison Davis. That's Chance Douglas for Hopkins. As the ball goes out of bounds, it will be a throw-in for St. Louis Park. 37-12 to go in the first half as the Orioles, in the midst of their 9-1-1 run, had a signature win in their season finale on October 6th when they beat the top-ranked team in Class A, the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights, 2-0. The Red Knights in Section 5A are the number 2 seed. They're also the defending Class A champions behind the number 1 seed in the section, the Totino Gray Seagulls. As Hopkins goes on the attack and it will go out of bounds, a throw-in for the Orioles. Ashley Aiken for Hopkins. Now it's Rafferty Kugler. The ball goes out of bounds and it will be a throw-in for the Orioles, which will be taken by Anna Jennison. There's Ellie Kent sending it upfield. Ellie's brother, Max, is a freshman at McAllister College. And it will be a throw-in for the Orioles. 35-43 to go in the first half. No score. Lavin Douglas for the Royals. And it will go out of bounds. And a throw-in for Hopkins. Good turnout tonight at the Hopkins Stadium. Jane Stevenson for St. Louis Park. Here comes an opportunity as it goes to the right side of the net. Chance Douglas picked up by the Orioles. Ellie Kent for St. Louis Park. It will be a throw-in for the Royals. Taken by Allison Davis. That's Abby Bremner. Bremner, who also plays lacrosse along with Samantha Bear for St. Louis Park. As Roethler will hang on with 34-28 to go in a scoreless first half. Goes off of Rachel Young. Here comes Kugler for the Orioles. Kugler going through a couple of defenders. Kugler has a shot blocked, and it will go out of bounds. And it will be a throw-in for the Orioles, which will be taken by Kugler. Lavin Douglas, a race for the ball taken by Maley Liss. Liss sends it upfield, but it will go out of bounds, and a throw-in for Hopkins with 33-20 to go in the first half. The Orioles' first three games were one-goal losses to Armstrong, Minneapolis Washburn, and Creighton Durham Hall. The one common thread with those three teams is they're in Section 6AA. Do we have the bracket, Paul, for the Section 6AA tournament? He will bring it up at the next stoppage, so we'll go over the bracket at that juncture. Meanwhile, Hopkins is on the attack. That's Ellen Frank for the Royals. Goes past Liss and out of bounds with 32-34 to go in the first half. And we will now have the 6AA girls bracket. The top-seeded Wayzata Trojans take on the Minneapolis South Tigers. Armstrong taking on the Creighton Durham Hall Raiders in St. Paul. And the Battle of Minneapolis is the second-seeded Washburn Millers, who have outscored their last six opponents 30-0, taking on their city conference rival, the Minneapolis Southwest Lakers. That's Abby Mandler for Hopkins. Now it's Kent going for Rafferty Kugler, but it's taken by Allison Davis. And it will go out of bounds with 31:43 to go in the first half. And we do have some finals from our tournament director, Ira Gerwitz. On the Section 6 AA Boys Tournament, the Wayzata Trojans, the top seed, shut out the Armstrong Falcons, 1-5. And the Minneapolis Washburn Millers beat the Cooper Hawks 4-2. So Hopkins will play Cooper. Hopkins will face Washburn. Thank you, Ira. It will be,
it could be 3 or 5.
Either a 3 or 5 o'clock on the turf field at Minneapolis Washburn. So we got Hopkins and Washburn, and Wayzata will face either Minneapolis South or Southwest. The game that's being played at Roosevelt due to the absence of whites in the South field. Back to the girls right here. And Abby Mandler for the Royals. Malaika Bigger-Ndavin for St. Louis Park. Going past Kugler and into the Hopkins bench with 30:26 to go in the first half. No score. It'll be a throw-in for the Royals. That'll be taken for the Orioles. That will be taken by Jennison. And there's a centering pass, but it goes past the box. 29:54 to go in a scoreless first half. Mandler, it will be offside. By the way, if you would like to order a copy of the Section 6 AA Girls quarterfinal game, go to www.parktv.org, or you can phone our viewer hotline at 952-924-2635. That's 952-924-2635, where you could talk to our producer-director, Paul Broden, who's giving us all the sights and sounds of the Section 6 AA Girls quarterfinal game, where the winner will play either Minneapolis Southwest or Minneapolis Washburn. There's a line drive, goes off of Jordan Petty, and there's a shot, but play is whistled dead. And it will be a goal kick for the Royals, a free kick. As we take another look at that last shot. Good defense by the Royals. Our first substitutions of the game will be Annika Vignes and Ava Bishop. Vignes wearing number 15 and Ava Bishop wearing 4. There's Bishop. Racing for the ball is Balfour. Her sister Ariana played briefly during the season, coming up from the junior varsity roster. Here's Mandler. Mandler with a shot, it rolls over to Roethler. We'll make the save with 27:12 to go in the first half. And there is a high kick. Kugler for the Orioles. Goes off of Ellie Kent. Kent, a sophomore, on the Orioles as the ball goes into one of the officials. It'll be a throw-in for the Royals. Sent upfield by Chance Douglas. Goes off of Aiken. Racing for the ball is Samantha Bear. And going for the ball is Stevenson, one of the captains for St. Louis Park, as Roethler plays out of the net to make the save with 26:07 to go in the first half. She sends the ball high and goes past Kugler. Goes off of Kugler and in front of the Oriole bench. Goes by Stevenson and into Roethler. She will send it upfield. That's Douglas. Chance Douglas goes off of Stevenson. Racing for the ball is Bear and will go upfield and pass David Bishop and out of bounds. The ball remains in. Goes off of Balfour. Chance Douglas trying to center the ball, but it's intercepted by Annika Vignes. It will be a corner kick for the Royals. 24 and a half minutes to go in a scoreless first half. There's a centering pass broken up by the Orioles. That was a good defensive play by Alex Balfour. With 24 minutes to go in the first half, and Roethler will take the goal kick for St. Louis Park. There's a race for the ball. List going after it. Goes off of Vignes. Vignes defended by Kylie Newcomb. Correction, that was Abby Mandler, 13. Roethler plays out of the net on the right side to make the save. .23:06 to go in the first half. Goose eggs on the board. In case you've just joined us, the St. Louis Park boys had their season end by the Hopkins Royals 2-0. Clarence Wea and Andy Barris scored for Hopkins to send the Royals into the semifinals against the Minneapolis Washburn Millers Saturday afternoon. As the ball goes behind the St. Louis Park bench. 22:33 to go in a scoreless first half. Chance Douglas goes past Stevenson. Now it's Kugler who sends it upfield for the Orioles. And it will go out of bounds. There are a couple of substitutions for St. Louis Park. Abby Bremner is back in for the Orioles. And Annika Hansen enters the game for the Orioles. Kylie Newcomb enters for Hopkins.
Annika Hansen.
It'll be a throw-in for the Orioles. Goes past Bigorondade. And it will go out of bounds. Goes off of Bremner, who also plays lacrosse for St. Louis Park. That's Aiken. Aiken tries to center the ball, but Balfour deflects it for the Orioles. There will be a foul on the play. It'll be a free kick for the Orioles. 21 minutes to go in a scoreless first half. Balfour will take the free kick for St. Louis Park. Now it's Bigorondade. As Isabel Olsen sends it upfield for the Royals. Bigorondade, it looks like Benji Kent will send in another substitution. Samantha Bear is awaiting her return to the game. And Bear will come back in for the Orioles. With 20-20 to go in the first half. Nothing on the board as Kugler will take a breather. Another Oriole getting set to check in. It looks like it's Sydney Martinez. But her number is a bit obscured by the green pinning. That's Bear for the Orioles. Goes off of Bremner. And Bremner regains possession and will go out of bounds with 19:45 to go in the first half. With both football teams from St. Louis Park and Benilde St. Margaret's on the road, there's still high school volleyball left to be played, and Park TV will be on hand this coming Monday, October 17th, as the St. Louis Park girls volleyball team wraps up the regular season against the Bloomington Kennedy Eagles. Ellie Kent is set to return for the Orioles. Racing for the ball is Bishop. And sending it upfield is Allison Davis. Now it's Bishop for the Orioles going past Bigorondade. As Liss takes a bit of a fall, the ball goes out of bounds. It will be a throw-in for St. Louis Park. As Kent returns to the game and Sydney Martinez will enter. Also for the Orioles with 18:34 to go in the first half. Last time Hopkins played was the regular season finale where they lost to the Eden Prairie Eagles 2-0. They also played Benilde St. Margaret's during the regular season and lost to the Red Knights 3-1. They started out the season with a record of 4-0. As two more substitutions head into the game. Young's back in as well as Kugler for the Orioles with 17:37 remaining in the first half. +107 have been played between the two teams and not a ball has entered the net. There will be a corner kick for Hopkins. As there was a good crowd on hand tonight at Hopkins High School. The ball goes off of Jane Stevenson and will go out of bounds. It will also be a throw-in for the Royals. and take two on the throw-in. Goes past Bremner. As Roethler playing in the left side will make the save with 16:26 to go in the first half. The ball goes past Kent and headed by Mandler. Headed by Both Balfour. Now it's Chance Douglas for the Royals, sends it upfield. Kicked upfield by Stevenson. And it goes by Samantha Bear and out of bounds. And Mandler waits to return to the game. And she does with 15:39 to go in the scoreless first half. It'll be a throw-in for the Royals. A high kick from Davis. Taken upfield by Bremner. Davis sends it upfield, going past Kent. And Stevenson will send it upfield as well as Annika Vignes. Now it's Martinez for the Orioles. Martinez defended by Chance Douglas. That's Lavin Douglas for Hopkins, as well as Mandler. Both teams showing some solid defense in the first half. Samantha Bear will throw it in for the Orioles. 14:25 to go in the first half. Martinez will throw it in instead of Bear. Now it's Balfour for the Orioles. Balfour sends it upfield. And it will go to head coach Keith Pavelka of the Royals, as Martinez will throw it in. 13:58 to go in the first half, as Kent will send it upfield for the Orioles. That's Chance Douglas for Hopkins. And Aiken. Here comes an opportunity, and Roethler makes the save. Anna Roethler with another save for St. Louis Park. Will we have a replay in that one? It looks like we will not, as Roethler will send the ball upfield. That's Isabel Olsen for the Royals. And Stevenson sends it upfield. Now it's Davis for Hopkins, and Roethler will make another save. 13:05 to go in the first half. Roethler with a high kick goes toward Ellie Kent and past Vignes. Now it's Kugler for the Orioles. Kugler going down the left side. And still in possession. Kugler trying to send the ball upfield, and it will go out of bounds. As Jennison and Bigorandavi await their return to the game. It will also be a corner kick for St. Louis Park, as Jennison and Bigorandavi are back in for the Orioles with 12:09 to go in a scoreless first half.
The number 29, Malika Bigorandavi.
Here comes the corner kick. It will also go out of bounds. It will be a throw-in for the Orioles. 11:38 to go in the first half. There's Kent for the Orioles. Goes past Bigorondavi. As Chance Douglas has the ball for Hopkins and defended by ball four. Now it's Bigorondavi for St. Louis Park. As Hopkins is playing solid defense, the Royals on the attack. A high shot goes wide to the right of Roessler. 11 minutes to go in a scoreless first half as Abby Bremner returns to the game for St. Louis Park. Annika Vignus will take a breather. Roessler will send it upfield. Now it's Kent for St. Louis Park. Goes off of Rachel Young. And it will go out of bounds. It will be a throw-in for the Orioles. Both Hopkins and St. Louis Park were members of the Classic Lake Conference. And go even further back, they were in the Lake Conference. Various incarnations. St. Louis Park was in the Lake South. And in the Lake North were Hopkins Lindbergh, which is now the current site of Hopkins High School, and Eisenhower, which is now an elementary school just off of Highway 7. As the ball goes out of bounds, 9:35 remaining in the first half. One of the top players to come out of St. Louis Park is now playing at the Division I level, and she is a senior this year, Lauren Miller. Miller was a six-year starter for the Orioles. And she scored 75 career goals in her six-year career with St. Louis Park before moving on to North Dakota State, where she was named the Player of the Year last season in her junior year. Mandler is back in for Hopkins. With 8:55 to go in the first half. Lauren Miller was a starter from seventh grade until she graduated. One of the great players to come out of St. Louis Park. As the Orioles go back on the attack. Ellie Kent sends it upfield. Goes past Kugler and out of bounds. 8:17 to go in the first half. That's Bigorondavi for the Orioles, and she will throw it in. As Section 6AA looks very competitive this season with six teams with winning records. The only two that don't have winning records are the two Minneapolis schools Southwest, who St. Louis Park beat during the regular season, and another team the Orioles beat, the Minneapolis South Tigers, who go up against the top-seeded Wayzata Trojans tonight. Another successful season for longtime Trojan head coach Tony Pesnecker, who played right here in Minnesota with the Kicks. One of his assistants was also a Minnesota Kick, Stuart Jump. It will be a throw-in for the Royals with 6:55 to go in the first half. The Kicks began 40 years ago at Metropolitan Stadium. Their very first game on May 8th, 1976. There was a long line outside the stadium delaying the start of the game for about 15 minutes, so management decided to let in the fans for free. So, Paul, how would you have liked to see that game for free? That was the very first game in Minnesota Kicks history at Metropolitan Stadium. They were playing the San Jose Earthquakes on May 8, 1976. Back here 40 years later, the Hopkins in St. Louis Park, there was still no score with 6:05 to go in the first half. As Lavin Douglas sends it upfield for the Royals. As Maley Liss is being tended to by the athletic trainer for St. Louis Park. We hope she's all right. Ball four. Now it's Jennison over to Samantha Bear, and play is whistled dead with 5:24 to go in the first half. Still zeros on the board at Hopkins High School as Anna Giesting will send it upfield for the Royals. It will be a throw-in for Hopkins, taken by Davis. Chance Douglas defended by Bears. Chance will send it upfield. Now it's Isabel Olsen for the Royals, and she takes a shot and scores. A line drive kick from the right side goes past Anna Rothler. Because the goal came at 4:46 and the clock didn't stop until 4:39, the official time of the goal would be 35:14 of the first half. 1-0 in favor of the Hopkins Royals as we take another look at the goal by Isabel Olsen.
And it's a 1-0 Hopkins Royals goal scored by number 7, Isabel Olsen.
Isabel Olsen. One of 11 seniors for head coach Keith Pavelka. It's a 1-0 now. The Orioles are on the attack. Here comes a shot, but it goes into traffic. Now Chance Douglas sends it upfield for Hopkins. And an Oriole is down. The trainer will come on with 3:58 to go in the first half. It doesn't look like a serious injury as Bigorondavi gets up. But we're fine. As we take another look, and it looks like she goes down after that block. And we're finding out who the injured player is on the screen being tended to. It is Maley Liss. As Liss will come off the field. The Oriole fans cheer. And we hope that Liss is all right. She is one of 6 seniors on the Orioles. Along with Rothler, Bremner, Bear, and backup goalkeeper Anya Lindell Paulson. Stop her. as Jennison will throw it in for the Orioles. Now it's Chance Douglas for Hopkins. That's Lavin Douglas. Here comes Chance Douglas, defended by Bremner. Bremner trying to get the ball away as well as ball four. And the ball will go out of bounds with 3:11 to go in the first half. A one-goal lead for Hopkins. Isabel Olson scoring the goal at 35-14 to give Hopkins the one-goal lead. And there's a high kick. Rosler playing right out of the net, and it will go out of bounds with 2:52 to go in the first half. Rothler with the goal kick. Goes off of Chance Douglas. There's action in front, but goes off of Sydney Martinez. 2:12 to go in the first half. That's Bigorandavi for the Orioles. As the ball goes downfield, Bear goes after the ball as well as Allison Davis. That's Frank for the Orioles, for the Royals. 1:45 to go in the first half. One goal lead for Hopkins. The goal coming at 35-14 by Isabel Olson. Bear going after the ball as well as Chance Douglas. Now it's Kugler for the Orioles, defended by Lawrence Sperling. And there is a foul called with 1:14 to go in the first half. Olson will take the free kick as we're now in the final minute of the first half. Anna Jennison will take the free kick for St. Louis Park. Now it's Martinez for the Orioles. 34 seconds to go in the first half. Ball four. Now it's Chance Douglas for Hopkins. That's Aiken. Aiken trying to center the ball, and it goes into the right corner of the net with 17 seconds remaining in the first half. Rothler will try to get the ball upfield. 8 seconds to go. As the first half will come to a close at Hopkins High School. With the score, the Hopkins Royals won. The St. Louis Park Orioles, nothing. We will take a break and we'll be back with the second half of the 2016 Section 6AA Girls Soccer quarterfinal game between the St. Louis Park Orioles and the Hopkins Royals. You're watching the 2016 Section 6AA Girls Soccer Tournament on ParkTV Sports.
You're always trying to keep your kids safe, right? What about preventing concussion? Concussion can happen anywhere, on a sports field, at the park, even at home. So you need to know the ABCs. Assess the situation, be alert for signs and symptoms, and contact a healthcare professional. Most kids recover completely, but seek care to help them get better faster. To learn more, go to cdc.gov/concussion. Keep kids safe. It's as simple as ABC.
Howard Lulosh back at Hopkins High School as we're getting ready for the second half of the 2016 Section 6AA Girls quarterfinal game between the St. Louis Park Orioles and the Hopkins Royals, with the host Royals leading by a goal which was scored by Isabel Olsen at 35-14 of the first half. The second half is now underway with Olsen, who scored the only goal so far for the Royals. That's there for St. Louis Park. And it'll be a throw-in for the Orioles. 21 seconds into the second half. The winner faces the Battle of Minneapolis winner, Southwest and Washburn, two teams the Orioles have played against this season. The Orioles beating the Lakers and an early season loss to the Millers, which was also the home opener for the St. Louis Park girls, a 1-0 defeat. As Liss will throw it in for the Orioles. Now it's Stevenson. And it will go out of bounds. It will be a throw-in for the Orioles. That's Bear for St. Louis Park. And a throw-in for Hopkins. Isabel Olsen. Going for the ball is Rachel Young. But it's sent upfield by Anna Giesting. A high kick. Goes off of Liss. And out of bounds, it'll be a throw-in for the Royals. As Liss comes in to try to knock the ball away. There will also be a foul on the play with just about 2 minutes gone by in the second half as Liss is down once again, which will cause the clock to stop with 37:58 to go in regulation time. Jeremy Shepard, the trainer for St. Louis Park, taking a look at Maylee Liss. And Benji Kent, the head coach of the Orioles, is also on the field. And Sydney Martinez will be back in for St. Louis Park. As for the second time of the game, Liss is down. She was out of the game for a while in the first half, but she did come back. And it looks like she's about to get up. As the fans give her a round of applause, and she will get off the field. With Martinez checking into the game. As the reserve players for St. Louis Park are bundled up in blankets, it got chilly this morning. The temperature was in the high 20s. But warmed up till around the 50s. We're not here to give you the weather picture right now. We're here for soccer as play restarts. Goes off of Jennison. Now it's Balfour for the Orioles. Goes past Young. Now it's Bremner. That's bigger than Davi. It'll be a throw-in for the Royals with 36:55 to go in regulation time. And another throw-in for the Royals, for the Orioles. as the ball goes out of bounds once again. It will be a goal kick for the Royals. With 36-16 left in regulation, one goal lead for Hopkins, the lone goal scored by Isabel Olsen at 35-14. And that's been the difference so far for the third seeded Hopkins Royals. That's Ellie Kent for St. Louis Park. Kent sends it upfield. Going past Rachel Young and out of bounds. And it will be a corner kick for the Orioles with Rafferty Kugler on the corner kick. And it looks like Liss will be coming back in for St. Louis Park. Liss is okay. There's a high corner kick and a high header going wide to the right of Petty. And Liss will return to the game for the Orioles, and Martinez will come out. 35:05 remaining in regulation time. One goal lead for the Hopkins Royals. As it'll be a goal kick for Hopkins. Ellie Kent for St. Louis Park goes past Rafferty Kugler. Now it's Lavin Douglas. Here's Kent defended by Lavin Douglas. Goes past Bear. There's a race for the ball and it will go out of bounds. It will be a throw-in for Hopkins. That's Olsen for Hopkins. Jennison sends it upfield. Coming out of the net is Petty, playing far out on the left side. She'll send the ball upfield past Bigarandavi. There's Olsen. As it goes past there, the ball will go out of bounds. 33:45 left in regulation as Liss will throw it in for St. Louis Park as they hope to get a scoring opportunity to even the game. Jennison sends it upfield, intended for Rafferty Kugler. And Gesundheit to Ira. Ira Gerwitz, the tournament director and one of our colleagues here at Park TV. One of the most knowledgeable men about soccer in this area. The ball remains in bounds. Ellie Kent for the Orioles. Kent has it knocked away by Mantler. Now it's Jennison to Bigarandavi. Bigarandavi on the left side goes out of bounds and it'll be a throw-in for the Orioles. 32.5 minutes left in regulation time. Now there's Kent double-teamed. Here comes an opportunity on the left side, but it will go wide past Petty. It will also be a goal kick for the Royals. As we take another look at the opportunity that went by the boards, because the ball went wide to the left and past Jordan Petty. Goes past Young and taken by Stevenson and it goes out of bounds. A throw in for Hopkins. That's Balfour for the Orioles. Here comes an opportunity, but it will enter the net. The goal coming at 48-52, and the Hopkins Royals now have a two-goal lead. As we take another look at the goal. We'll find out in just a moment. It looked like it was Chance Douglas on the right side of the net.
It's 2-0. Hopkins Royals score 5. It's Chance Douglas.
It is Chance Douglas who puts the Royals ahead by 2 at the 48-52 mark. It'll be a throw-in for the Orioles with 30-37 remaining in regulation time. Chance Douglas scoring at 48-52. As the ball goes by the St. Louis Park bench, Bear will throw it in. And there will be another throw-in. Right now it's time for the Class AA Top 10. Number one, just like their male counterparts, the Stillwater Ponies. Wyzetta is second. The Rosemount Irish is third. Egan is fourth. Minneapolis Washburn is fifth. The Eastridge Raptors are sixth. Eastview is seventh. Andover is eighth. Another school from the Northwest Suburban Conference, the Centennial Cougars, are ninth. Rounding out the top 10, the Lakeville North Panthers. In Class A, the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights remain number one despite their loss to St. Louis Park on October 6th. Visitation is second. Satino Grace is third. St. Paul Academy is fourth, followed by Matamidi fifth. The Princeton Tigers are sixth. Blake is seventh. Hill Murray is eighth. Holy Angels ninth. And rounding out the top 10, the Orono Spartans. As the ball will go out of bounds, it'll be a corner kick with 29:05 remaining in regulation. And there is a high corner kick, and it will go wide to the left of Roethler. As it looks like Annika Vignos will get ready to return for St. Louis Park. On a corner kick for the Royals. And there's a shot, and Roethler playing in the center of the net makes the save. She sends it high and deep, going over Rachel Young. Young in possession for the Orioles. Goes off of Kugler, and it's wide to the left of Petty, as Vignes will return to the game for St. Louis Park with 28 minutes to go in regulation. A two-goal lead for Hopkins. The winner plays Washburn or Southwest on Saturday afternoon. It will go out of bounds, and it will be a throw-in for the Orioles taken by Jennison. Now it's Bear for St. Louis Park. Goes off a Hopkins player, and once again Bear will throw it in. Young for St. Louis Park. Bremner will send it upfield as Petty plays out of the net to make the save. And there is a high kick. And it will be a throw-in for the Royals. 26:37 to go. As the ball goes past Jennison. As Aiken goes down, there's a foul in St. Louis Park. A free kick for Hopkins. And fortunately, that did not go over the air. Meanwhile, Chance Douglas will take a free kick for Hopkins. As Roethler will send it high. Going past Young and headed by Geistling. Geistling. And it will be a throw-in for St. Louis Park. 25:40 to go in regulation time. Rachel Young. The ball going past Jennison as well as Balfour as Hopkins goes on the attack. Here's Chance Douglas for Hopkins. Douglas with a goal in the books and it's taken by Aiken. Aiken looking for a player in a white jersey. Aiken with a shot and it will go over the goal. It will be a goal kick for St. Louis Park.
Fans out there in the stands tonight, I have some news for you. Hopkins Royals volleyball just won 3-0 tonight, this evening. Give them a round of applause.
There was an announcement that the Hopkins girls volleyball team was victorious tonight. A top 10 team in Class 3A, led by Golden Gopher signee Jasmine Martin. Martin also played basketball for the Royals until she decided to concentrate on volleyball. She will be a welcome addition next season for Gopher head coach Hugh McCutcheon. As we're down to 24:10 to go in regulation time, and Petty with a high kick, headed by Jennison, and also by Bear. There's a line drive. Taken by Lavin Douglas. Douglas, one of only three sophomores on the Royals. As Bishop and Kent return for St. Louis Park. The other two sophomores are backup goalkeeper Abby Ansel and Mary O'Neill. O'Neill has not yet seen action tonight for the Royals, as well as Ansel. Bear racing for the ball. And picks it up, but loses the ball to Lauren Sperling. It will go out of bounds, and it will be a throw-in for the Orioles. That's Bear in the corner. Bear trying to center the ball toward Bishop. Now it's Bigger and Davi with an opportunity. Bigger and Davi scores! Malika Bigger and Davi cuts the lead to 2-1. As we take another look, Bigger and Davi in the center slot puts it past Petty. Coming at the 57-19 mark. And the Orioles are back in the ball game, trailing by one.
Park Orioles have pulled one back, making it 2-1. Goal scored by Malika Brandavi.
Abby Bremner returned.
Abby go Bremner.
Bremner back in for the Orioles, who now trail 2-1 with 22:18 left in regulation. Don't go away, folks. There's plenty more soccer to go. as the ball is headed by Cougar, and now it's Bishop for the Orioles. Now it's Lavin Douglas for Hopkins. Here's an opportunity for Bear. Bear trying to get possession. Bear with a shot. Petty with a save. As we take another look at the shot by Samantha Bear. The ball deflected over the net by Jordan Petty as the clock continues to run. And a corner kick from Bigarandavi. Penny will make the save. And she will send it high and deflected by Bear. Bear sends it high and goes off of Ava Bishop. Now it's Ellie Kent for the Royal Orioles. Racing for the ball is Lavin Douglas, and it will be picked up by Petty. 20 and a half minutes to go in regulation time. A one-goal lead for Hopkins. Malaika Bigarandavi scoring at 57-19 to cut the Hopkins lead to a single goal. Bigarandavi goes past Kent and goes over Bremner as Hopkins goes on the attack. There's Isabel Olson, knocked away by Liss, and it will go out of bounds with 19:48 to go in regulation. Reminder once again, if you would like to order a copy of the 2016 Section 6AA Girls quarterfinal game between St. Louis Park and Hopkins, go to www.parktv.org or phone or viewer hotline at 952-924-2635. My apologies, I gave the wrong number during the boys game, but the last four digits are 2635. Isabel Olson for Hopkins going after the ball, and it goes out of bounds with 19:06 left in regulation. That's Aiken centering the ball. Here comes a shot. Goes wide to the left of Roeffler. It will be a goal kick for the Orioles. That's Sperling. Sperling goes between a couple of Oriole defenders. As it looks like Kugler's racing for the ball, it'll be a throw-in for the Orioles. 18 minutes remaining in regulation time. This year, the state soccer tournament returns inside to the new U.S. Bank Stadium after playing two seasons in the freezing cold on the campus of St. Cloud State University. The prep bowl will also return to its usual slot after Thanksgiving at the new home of the Vikings as Roeffler makes the save. And this year, for the first time, the high school football all-star game will be played just after the regular season. Also at U.S. Bank Stadium, instead of playing in midsummer in either St. Cloud or at TCF Bank Stadium. Bear knocks it away. 17 minutes to go, and it will go out of bounds, and a throw-in for the Orioles that will be taken by Samantha Bear. Bear races for the ball and tries to center it. Now it's Bremner for the Orioles. Bremner, but a sliding tackle by the Royals. Good solid defense near the penalty area. Bigger and Davi on defense as the ball goes past Bremner. Bremner. That's Isabel Olsen, who has the first Hopkins goal, defended by Jennison. As the ball goes out of bounds, it will be a throw-in for the Royals. 16 minutes to go in regulation. The Orioles double team, and it will be a goal kick. Correction, it will be a corner kick. Isabel Olsen on the corner kick, and there's a shot, but it goes wide to the left of Roethler, and it will be a goal kick. Rachel Young is back in for the Orioles, and Sydney Martinez will take a breather. Not Sydney Martinez, it's Bigger and Davi. Bigger and Davi will take a breather. The ball going past Young, picked up by Lavin Douglas. It will be a throw-in for the Orioles. 14:51 remaining in regulation time. The St. Louis Park boys were eliminated by Hopkins in the opener, 2-0. Hopkins will play Washburn Saturday afternoon in Minneapolis. That's Bear for the Orioles. Going down. Play continues. It's Bear for the Orioles, but there's an Oriole down. They will stop the clock. As Benji Kent comes out along with trainer Jeremy Shepard, as we take another look at the collision around the 20-yard line. .01 remaining in regulation time, a one-goal lead for Hopkins. As Rachel Young is the injured player, as we take another look at the bracket, top-seeded Wyzetta facing Minneapolis South, Armstrong hosting the Crete and Durham Hall Raiders, and the Battle of Minneapolis in the bottom of the bracket, Southwest and Washburn, as Rachel Young comes off the field. Young, one of seven sophomores who will return next season for head coach Benji Kent. This is a team that has a good future ahead of them with a lot of young players, as Bear will throw it in. Bigger and Davi to Bremner. Goes off of Balfour. Now it's Balfour who overruns the ball, but It will go to Bear. Bear with a cross pass toward Ava Bishop, defended by Chance Douglas, and it will go. It will remain in bounds. Racing for the ball is Stevenson. 13:23 to go in regulation. As Roessler will hold on. She sends it high. And Liss will throw it in. Now it's Bigger and Davi for the Orioles. Olsen racing for the ball along with Liss. Now it's Liss for the Orioles. There's a centering pass toward the center area, but it goes nowhere. The ball remains in bounds. Goes off of Jennison and out of bounds. It'll be a throw-in for the Orioles. 12:02 to go in regulation. One goal lead for Hopkins. Each team scoring a goal in the second half. Chance Douglas for the Royals and Malaika Bigger-Ndavi for the Orioles. As Roessler will pick it up. Chance Douglas to Olsen. Olsen in the corner. Now it's Jennison. Sent upfield by Giesting. That's Mandler for Hopkins. Sent upfield by Jennison. And a Hopkins player goes down. There will be a foul on the play. It'll be a free kick for the Orioles as we take another look at the foul. And the clock will stop with 10:13 to go in regulation time. It looks like it will be a penalty kick. Here we go. They score. And who got the goal?
To Hopkins Royals. Chance Douglas
for their second goal of the game on a penalty kick coming at 69-49. Well, according to our producer director, Paul Broden, Chance Douglas tripped herself, but instead she got the penalty kick and made the most of it to put the ball in the net. It is a 3-1 lead in favor of the Hopkins Royals. As St. Louis Park has got to generate offense to get back in the ballgame. Oh, she did? Agrees that Chance Douglas tripped herself as we get a free kick for the Orioles. 9:04 to go in regulation as we get our first final of the evening. The Wayzata Trojans go to the semifinals with a 13-0 win over the Minneapolis South Tigers. That is not a typo. 13-0. You probably think that was a football score. As Kugler takes the kick, but it goes into traffic. Now it's bare for the Orioles. Goes through a couple of Hopkins defenders. Bishop races for the ball. It's in the corner. She tries to center it. Kicked away by Lavin Douglas. Now it's Bigger and Davi for the Orioles. 8:08 to go in regulation time. Back to the game right now, 7:14 to go in regulation time. It is a 3-1 lead in favor of the Royals. Now it's Bremner. Bremner with a back pass to Martinez. As we're down to 6:44 remaining. And another player is down for the Orioles, and the trainer has been pretty busy tonight. And this time the injured player is Sydney Martinez. Meanwhile, Newcomb is back in for Hopkins.
Royals, 15, Kylie Newcomb.
And Mandler takes a breather with 6:26 remaining in regulation time. There's Bishop. Sends it over to Kent. It'll be Kugler throwing it in for the Orioles. And Bishop will throw in for St. Louis Park, 5:45 remaining in regulation time. Now There's Kent who sends the ball upfield. That's fair for the Orioles. Goes past Bremner. 4:25 remaining in regulation time. 2-goal lead for Hopkins. Young going for the ball. Now it's Samantha Bear. Bear in front of the Oriole bench. Kicked upfield by Bishop. And play is whistled dead with 3:46 remaining. And Arroyo is down. But the clock will stop with 3:35 remaining. As hobbling off the field is Laura Frank. It looks like it's an ankle. She's being helped by one of the assistant coach. The assistant coach, Megan Schober. Mandler is back in for Hopkins. It'll be a throw-in for the Orioles with 3:27 to go. Balfour sends it upfield. Now it's Kugler. And Balfour regains possession. There's Ellie Kent for the Orioles. Kent defended by Mandler. Kent trying to pass to an orange jersey. Kent with a shot. Goes wide to the right of Petty. 2:58 remaining in regulation time. Now it's Bear, but it goes off of Sperling. 2:09 to go. Goes past Liss. .134 remaining as time is starting to run out on St. Louis Park. They need some quick goals. It'll be a throw-in for the Orioles. as Roessler will send the ball high. Goes off of Frank as we're in the final minute of the Section 6AA girls soccer quarterfinals. Goes off of Kugler. That's Balfour. Balfour tries to get a shot, and Petty will make the save with 36 seconds remaining in regulation. As Petty will send it high. 22 seconds to go. As the ball goes out of bounds, 15 seconds remaining. As the Hopkins Royals will advance into the Section 6AA semifinals, and the St. Louis Park Orioles season will come to an end.
There have it,
the final score is the Hopkins Royals 3, the St. Louis Park Orioles 1. Here's a recap of tonight's Section 6AA girls quarterfinal game between the St. Louis Park Orioles and the Hopkins Royals. Hopkins got on the board with a one goal in the first half with 4:46 remaining as Isabel Olson lined a shot from the left side past Anna Roessler into the net. 1-0 at the half in favor of the Royals. Hopkins went up by 2 in the second half as Chance Douglas scored from the right side, and it was 2-0 in favor of the Royals. But St. Louis Park was not out of the game just yet as Malika Bigarandavi would score from the center slot, and it was a 2-1 game in favor of Hopkins. Could the Royals tie the game and send it into overtime? The answer would be no, as Chance Douglas was tripped in the penalty area and she was awarded a penalty kick. And she made the most of the opportunity by putting it past Roessler to clinch the win for the Hopkins Royals, 3-1. The Hopkins Royals advance into the semifinals of the 6AA tournament. Their record is now 11 wins, 5 losses, and 1 tie. They will play the winner of Minneapolis Southwest and Washburn Saturday afternoon. The St. Louis Park Orioles conclude their season with a record of 9 wins, 5 losses, and 1 tie. We just got a score in from our tournament director Ira Gerwitz that the Washburn Millers beat Hopkins 2-0. So it will be Hopkins playing at Washburn Saturday afternoon. But the future looks pretty bright for the Oriole girls soccer team. They lose only a half dozen players to graduation, including goalkeeper Anna Roessler. They lose their backup Anya Lindell Paulson. They also lose Maylee Liss, Abby Bremner, Samantha Bear, and Jane Stevenson. But they return a lot of young players from this year's team, and they could make a run at defending their Metro West Conference Championship that they won this season, with a signature win coming in their last regular season game against the top-ranked team in Class A, the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights. So the future looks pretty bright for girls soccer under the leadership of Benji Kent at St. Louis Park. So this will wrap up the soccer season for both St. Louis Park teams. The Benilde St. Margaret's boys and girl teams are in Section 5A competition with the finals next Thursday at St. Louis Park High School. For our producer-director, Paul Broden, and the rest of our Park TV crew, this is Howard Luloff saying goodbye and reminding you once again the final score in the Section 6AA girls soccer tournament, the Hopkins Royals 3, the St. Louis Park Orioles 1, the Hopkins Royals ending the St. Louis Park Orioles season. So long, everybody.